Hello, I'm Gavin Hoey and you're watching another Photoshop tutorial. Now today I'm going to show you how to create this hand-painted border effect. And not only is it a nice hand-painted border, but have a look around the edge here and you can see it has this lovely kind of textured look as well. Now this might look like it's fairly complicated to make, but nothing could be further from the truth. In fact, if you've got Photoshop CS4 or newer, then you can do this in just a few minutes. And I'll show you exactly how it's done. Okay, so first of all, I'm using Photoshop CS5, and what I need to do is to get this image, or at least the original image, which is down here, into Adobe Camera Raw. Now, if it's already a RAW file like mine is, you can just double-click it and in you go. But if you're using Bridge or Mini Bridge, right-click it, and you can choose Open in Camera Raw, and then it'll bring in the file, whether it's a JPEG or a RAW file. But of course, I hope you all shoot RAW, really. Okay, so what are we going to do? Well, I'm not going to make any changes here. I'm just going to jump straight to the adjustment brush. Now, as I said before, adjustment brush, Photoshop CS4 and newer, you have this tool. So let's click on that and we'll set a few things up. What do I need to set up? Well, exposure. I'm going to paint in a nice bright border with the adjustment brush. So I need to make it brighter, and I'm going to do that by increasing the exposure to +2. Now, everything else I'm going to leave untouched. But the size of the brush, I'm going to take that down to a very small brush, around about 5. The feathering, I'm going to put to 100. The flow to 100. And the density to 100. And now, the most important thing, and the thing that gives this border its look and feel, is auto mask. Now, normally, if you have auto mask turned on, and a big feather number, then it leaves some horrible sort of textured things behind it. But that's exactly what I want this time, because it works great as a border. So I'm going to put a tick here in auto mask. Now all I need to do is start in the top right corner, or any corner, it doesn't really matter, and just draw across like that. And when I go across, I'll get this lighter area, which is the first part of my border. Let's go check it, have a quick look. Yep, there it is. And you can see how it's leaving behind this sort of textured look. It's a thing that normally would be quite annoying. That's the auto mask at work. And that's the big feathered brush that's causing it. Now, normally I would try and avoid that at all costs. But here, that's exactly what makes this border so successful. Okay, let's fit it back on the screen and we'll just go around the other three sides. Going nice and quickly. There you go. So that's one edge done. But I want to do this a couple more times to build up the effect. So next, I'm going to click on the new brush to make a second adjustment brush. I'll increase the exposure by an extra stop, so we'll put it up to +3. And I'll increase the brush size 3 times bigger, up to 15. Okay, and then I'm just going to draw around the outside. Here we go. And that's going to leave a much larger version of the same thing we did before. So that's going to eat in further to the image. And then we're going to do that one more time. So back to new to make a third brush. Again, we're going to change the exposure, but we're going to put it back down to +2 stops. And I'll put the brush size back down to 5 like that. And yep, that's exactly the same as the first brush. I know, but trust me, it works. And around we go. Like that. And every time I do this, I get a very different result. And you'll find that sometimes bits disappear and sometimes they just stick on the edges. And that's absolutely fine. That's exactly what I would expect to happen. And it really adds to the border effect. Okay, all I need to do is to open the image now, which is just dropped off the bottom of the video. But there's the open image button and that will take us back into Photoshop. So there is the border, and if we go and have a little look, we can see that, yeah, that's got that really nice edge effect going on. That's exactly the look we were after. However, it's a little bit tight around the outside. Now, to complete the look, I need to make my canvas a little bit bigger. And I'm going to do that by going to Image, Canvas Size, and from here, I'm going to make sure my units are set as percent, and I'm going to add in 120% on both the width and the height. My extension color I'll make sure is set to white, because I want the new canvas, or the new bit of photograph if you like, to be white in color. Click OK and there you go. So now we can really see it, and now we've expanded the canvas we can see things like that sort of rough straight edge there, which is almost like a burnt in effect. And it's really good. It actually really enhances the look of the image. Now, one last little thing. I just want to put my name along the bottom. So I need to make a bit more canvas size for that. So let's go back to Image, Canvas Size. And this time I'm only going to change the height. I'll put in 110%. And I'll make sure it's anchored in the top center, like that. So when I click OK, the new bit of canvas only goes down to the bottom. Right, so I could go in here with the text tool and just type my name in, but for speed, I'll go grab one that I've already made. And we'll just drag it and drop it in like that. Lovely. Now, one last little tip here. If you want to make sure that the text is slap bang in the middle, what you do is you come to Select and All, and then get the Move tool, which I have right here. And then on the Options bar, come find the middle little one here. It's the Align Horizontal Centers. Click on that and it'll line it up dead center of the active selection. So there you go. I can get rid of the selection and we're done. There is my little hand-painted border effect in Photoshop in under 5 minutes. Now, if you want to find out more about me, don't forget to visit my website at www.gavtrain.com. I'm Gavin Hoey. Thanks for watching.